I'm ready to start sculpting. Let's jump in and start looking at the first stage of our sculpting process after we've remeshed. Now for me, one of the things that I like to do first is just to kind of get a wrangle, if you will, a handle on the current form of my sculpture. And I do that through smoothing. So I've gone over into my smoothing brush inside of my Blender sculpting tools. And my first goal here is just to kind of smooth out some of this chop. I want to start working with the base mesh itself to ensure that everything is, I have a good foundation. Let's just put it that way. By smoothing out some of these forms, I now have a foundation in which I can layer detail on top of. So let's go ahead and start that process. Now, if you look carefully at my mesh here, yeah, it's still pretty primitive in its form. I have a lot of work in front of me left to do. You know, look at this tail back here. Yeah, I got to start working on that. This is the time to start making some of the transitions. Think of this as our first attempt in blocking out the primary forms of the sculpture. At the end of this smoothing stage, we should be able to take a step back and view and understand our sculpture from that kind of macro view. We should be able to look at the overall silhouette and go, yep, that's a hammerhead shark or whatever it is that you're sculpting for your ocean animal. So let's go ahead and start this process. I got my smooth brush fired off here. And now what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna start working on this central mass first. I'm not gonna worry about these small little extraneous details yet. Working the central mass outward. That way the details or the overall form and structure of your central mass is leading the decision-making process for all the smaller details. The largest part of the sculpture is gonna be seen first. So we need to nail it. We need to get that kind of perfect before we go any further. So I'm gonna start working here. And when I was first blocking this out with a primitive shape, I think I just used a cylinder with one additional edge loop in the middle. So I'm gonna start kind of knocking this back a little bit. I got my symmetry turned on. Yeah, things are looking good. And I'm slowly gonna start kind of refining this transition in here. I'll make my brush just a little bit bigger. And the cool thing I like about working with this smooth brush is that it's gonna look at the total diameter of the brush head, and it's gonna try to smooth and attenuate all the polygons across that diameter. So if you're trying to make a big gradual change in form, make your brush real big, put the strength down real low, and you'll have a much subtler effect across the entirety of your mesh. The mistake that I see people making all the time when it comes to smoothing out their shapes is that their intensity is way too high. It's way too high. In addition, I'm gonna change my mat cap here real fast so you can see this next part. In addition, be mindful of the flow of the form as it goes across the mesh itself. Don't just sit there and go up and down. Your shape, this shape for me, isn't a up and down shape. It's a horizontal shape. So as I'm smoothing, I wanna start at the top and work my way to the bottom, or excuse me, start at the left and work my way to the right, from the head to the tail. We gotta be mindful of this direction. Yeah, and as I do it, I'm orbiting around. You'll find that I'm always orbiting and looking at my shape from a number of different angles. At times, if I wanted to, instead of using the smooth brush, yeah, maybe I'll go in and just grab the grab brush, this guy right here. I'm gonna make my brush real big, and I'm just gonna push it in just a little bit. Go back to my smooth brush and smooth out that shape. Again, going from the head to the tail. Yeah. Now don't worry about some of these little dimples and stuff. We're gonna take care of those as we go through the sculpting process. Remember, this is just kind of a concept piece at the moment. This is far from being a perfect polygonal mesh yet, right? We're gonna get there as we go through the stages. This is just our first stage. All right, now let's spend some time looking at this transition. The smoothing tool really helps us define these transitions. The reference that I've collected for my hammerhead shark shows me that this transition between the top fin and its body has a nice little gray, you know, kind of smooth cove to it. So let's go ahead and start establishing that. Make my brush a little bit smaller. Yeah. And again, I'm smoothing in the direction I want the shapes to flow. Don't do this, okay? Don't do that because it's smoothing in the wrong direction. If you go from the top to the bottom, you're going to get a much more controllable result. Yeah, now this back bit right here, I'm going to go in, and this is where you can use the grab tool as well. This first stage is all about just creating the structure that you need. I want a nice, yeah, something like that, a nice kind of arc on that fin. Holding down the shift key now. I'm going to smooth it out this direction, going from top to bottom as I work on this shape. It's going to take some time to get through this process. But look carefully at the sculpture that you're creating here and be mindful of the direction that you're smoothing it. Now, when it comes to big areas like this on the back, we have some big decisions that we now need to make. In addition to refining this really intense transition between the base of the cylinder and the fin itself, we also have to be mindful of some of the anatomy. This is a great time for us to start layering in some of those small little anatomical cues that's going to help the believability of our sculpture. At times, we're not necessarily going for realism. We're always going for believability. Even in a caricatured, cartoony piece, the feeling that the audience needs to invoke in their imagination is that this thing is real, that they can believe in it. It doesn't necessarily have to be realistic, but that it is a living, breathing creature, and that's that believability factor that we're always striving for. Let's go ahead and work on this a little bit more. I'm going to go back into my smooth brush here. And first things first, I'm going to start smoothing out this transition. It's just really intense. I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller. I'm going to smooth this way. Smooth from the head to the tail. You can also go from the tail to the back a little bit too. There we go. All right. So some of the problems that we saw before have been ironed out, smoothed out, which is cool. No pun intended. I apologize. But now I need to start layering in some additional mass. This is where the simple draw brush can come in. Now, my strength was at a value of 1 from a previous recording, so let me just run this down quite significantly. And I'm just going to, if you look carefully here, just adding some mass in here. Gets a little bit thin. Let's increase my strength. Gets a little bit thin. Yeah, there we go. The cool thing I like, one of the cool things I like about sculpting is that, you know, I've just made a mistake. I've added a little bit too much mass here. It kind of looks like a little bit of a little bop out there. I don't know what you want to call that. Kind of like maybe a suggestion that there's a little bone in there, which is not what I want at all. But this cool thing about sculpting is that we can try. We can make mistakes easily. And then I'm just going to hold down the shift key and smooth it out. No one is expecting any of us to be perfect on the first time. Sculptures are a process of experimentation. We almost find the sculpture in the clay that's in front of us. So give yourself a little compassion. Be patient with yourself. You'll get there. And if you're really struggling with finding your form, take a break. Go have a cup of tea, some coffee, your favorite beverage of whatever it is. Just relax for a couple minutes. Let your brain decompress and get a little separation from the sculpture before you come back to it. Now I'm using this as an opportunity to add a little bit of mass in the tail itself. Now they're very, I want just a small little indication, especially towards the base of the tail, that there's some muscle in there, and then I want it to go flat. And this is just something that I'm doing for me. You almost never have flat, complete flat planes, if you will, in nature itself. So I'm just going to add a little bit of volume in here. And the sculpt draw brush is such a great way for us to do that. Another good one is the inflate tool. The inflate one is this one. Just as a demonstration, the inflate, is just going to take the area right around the brush, and it's just going to push it straight out along its normal. Hopefully you guys can see that. I'm going to hit undo. Another good one. You'll find that my two favorite brushes when it comes to just slowly pushing things out are the sculpt draw brush and the inflate brush. They're just really kind of good. Okay. Let's go in here. Now I'm just going to keep cruising around. Yeah, let's work on these little small fins down here at the back. Let me make my brush a little bit bigger. I'm going to go back into my sculpt draw brush. Just give it a little bit of mass. Got a little bit of deflation, if you will, when we did the remesh. That's okay. We can fix it. Just gonna smooth it out a little bit. Oh yeah, that smoothing from the top to the bottom is really helping in this particular situation. Now it feels as though the surface is actually transitioning. There's a small little cove in there, and that's working out really well. I'm gonna hold down the control key, and I'm gonna push in underneath, and then smooth out just to kind of give it a little bit of a negative area in there in between these fins. That's something you see in anatomy. The cool thing about ocean animals is that they're gigantic torpedoes, right? They're just tubes for the most part. So we want really nice, smooth, flowing curves across the length of our shape. Yeah, not bad. Not bad, I like this. Okay, so I got a tremendous amount of work. I'm gonna finish smoothing out some of this stuff here real fast before we go any further. Yeah, now I'm paying attention to how the mass and the volume is working. I smoothed out the shape, but it's just a little bit thin here in the center, and it's for two reasons. And if you look real carefully, let's go back into a different mat cap real fast. This just shows the power of the mat caps. Yeah, I can. As I orbit around, I'm looking at where the specular highlight, the bright spots are falling on the mesh itself, and I'm seeing that there's a small little hole here. Well, not a hole, just a low spot on the curve itself. And I need to refine that. And I can use the smooth brush, which is the correct one to use. I want to make my brush a little bit bigger. Yeah, I know you guys can't see that. Let me change my matte cap back to gray. I'll grab my smooth brush. And with a much larger brush, it's going to smooth across a much larger area, which is going to very quickly resolve some of those problems I was having before. Yeah, now as I look around the front here, I see a real nice consistent curve, which is what I'm after. It no longer looks like a square has been stuck into a cylinder. I'm starting to suggest that there is a natural connection between these two parts of our object. And that's the big goal of this stage, is to start crafting those natural connections. And I need to go in and give it a little bit of mass. I'm going to use the sculpt draw brush here. These initially started off as cubes. Make my brush a little bit bigger. I'm going to see if I can just kind of shoot it down the center here. Yeah, maybe instead of the sculpt draw brush, again, this is kind of going back to experiments. Sometimes you try something to go, nope, that's not going to work. Let's try the inflate. I'm just going to inflate out. Think of the inflate tool kind of like blowing up a balloon. And you're blowing up both sides of the balloon. Yeah, I like that. Right in here. Make the brush a little bit smaller. Let's inflate in here as well. There are no straight lines or flat surfaces in nature. Everything has a little bit of a curve to it. Yeah, I think I may have went a little too far. As I look at this top cove here, it's not sitting with me right. My spidey sense is tingling a little bit, and I'm going to listen to it. I'm going to use the grab brush and just kind of push this in. In doing so, I've made a small little divot in the form up here, so I'm going to hold down shift and just kind of smooth it out a little bit. Then we'll continue on. Feel free to jump around your mesh. Some folks, they'll start in the tail, then go to the head, then the fins and the body. I like to start in the center mass and then go somewhere from that location in the center mass. Let's just knock back some of these corners. This looks and feels. Yeah, I'm holding down the shift key. This looks and feels like a something. Well, like a heart, like a square shoved into a shape. And I'm just using the smooth brush, holding down shift. Yeah, sometimes you run into problems like this that you can't fix with the sculpting engine. I can sit here and I can grab and push and pull that until the cows come home. It's always just going to be sticking up there, this little tooth look thing here. So I'm going to go into edit mode real fast. And this is really kind of speaks to the power of having all of these tools built into one application. I'm going to go into edit mode. Turn my x-ray drawing on, so I grab both sides. I'm just grab those top two polygons, and I'm just going to move them. I'm going to move them down. really, I think my solution here isn't moving those polygons down. I want to move this one up. And maybe that one out just a little bit. Cool, let's go back into sculpt mode. Yeah, that solved my problems. I'm going to my smooth brush here real fast. Smooth it out just a little bit. And I think my brush is too big in this moment. Yeah, there we go. It was too big when it was trying to capture too big of an area for me to get the result that I'm after. Okay. I know often this is like watching paint dry, so I'm not going to go too much further in this video. You have a tremendous amount of work in front of you when it comes to the sculpting of your own ocean animal. But this is the process. We start with the smooth tool, and we start slowly ironing out, if you will, all of these details. And we do it in small passes. It's impossible to sculpt a hammerhead shark in one sitting, but we do want to go it in small passes. There is no wrong answer to this process. Resist the idea of going fast, and I think you're going to find that the end result is going to be something that you're quite proud of.